Hi guys, I'm Nancy, and I'm going to show you how to do synthetic division. So synthetic division is just a fast way of dividing one polynomial by x plus a number or x minus a number. So let's look at an example. Okay, say you have this synthetic division problem. Your first step is to draw a little corner here, like that, and you're going to place a number there. So the number that you put there is whatever makes your bottom of your fraction equal zero. So in this case, if we plugged in 2 for x, we would get 0 in the denominator. So we put 2 as the constant. Basically, whatever the number was in your bottom of your fraction, your denominator, you want to use the opposite sign version of that number. So since we had negative 2 in the denominator, we're going to put positive 2 here in the corner. If we instead had positive 2, x plus 2 in the bottom, we would have put negative 2 here in the corner. Next step, take every coefficient from your polynomial on the top, which are 3, negative 5, 1, and negative 2, and put them in a row here down below. So we have 3, negative 5, 1, and negative 2. Next step, draw just a horizontal line here below, leaving one row of space like that. Then we want to drop down this number like that and write it again down here below. So drop down the 3 and write it at the bottom. Next, you're going to take that number 3 and multiply it by our constant, 2. So 3 times 2 gives us 6, and we write it here in the second row, second column. So that step was take your 3 and multiply by your constant and write the answer here. Okay, then you're just going to add the two numbers in the column. In this case, we get negative 5 plus 6 is positive 1. Then we're just going to repeat all the steps. So 1, we're going to multiply by our constant 2, and we get 2. So that step was, again, multiply by 2. Then again, we're going to add the two numbers in the column. 1 plus 2 equals 3. Finally, one more time, multiply our 3 by the constant 2 times 2. We get 6. And one last time, add the numbers in the column. Negative 2 plus 6 gives us positive 4. And that's it. Okay, you're done with the division. And these first three numbers are your coefficients of your new polynomial. And this last final number is your remainder. Here's how we write your final answer. You're going to write 3 and then x squared. This first term will always have an x power 1 less than what you started with originally. Since our highest x power was x cubed, our answer is going to start with an x squared term. So 3x squared plus one term lower would be 1x, x to the first power, plus 3, just a constant. And your remainder, you will just write as 4 over your denominator, x minus 2. And that's your answer. So what trips people up is that sometimes you'll get a polynomial where there's a missing term. Say you didn't have an x squared term here. You would actually need to put a zero term as a placeholder instead. So if there was no x squared term, for instance, you would actually put zero here. So remember to do that. Another thing to remember is that sometimes you don't have a remainder. Sometimes you'll get zero as your last number in the final column of your synthetic division, and that's fine. That just means that you won't have a fraction as your last term. That won't even be there, and you'll just have a polynomial. Okay, so to summarize, the steps for synthetic division are right here in the corner the number that makes the bottom of your fraction zero, write the coefficients of the polynomial from the top of your fraction. If there's a term missing, put zero instead. Bring down the first number, multiply it by your constant, write the answer here. Add the column, repeat those steps until you get to the end of your synthetic division, and then write your final answer using those numbers. Good luck! I hope this helped you understand how to do synthetic division. I know synthetic division is super fascinating. It's okay, you don't have to like it. But if this video helped you, please click like below or subscribe.